It is a new year, and each day in this year is like a blank chapter in the book of your life. The pen is in your hand today. It is your chance to write a beautiful story for you and for all to read. What will you write, or what will be written? A year from now, you will either possess more of what God created you to be, or less. You will either live and love more like Jesus did, or less like Jesus did. So today, at the beginning of the year, you can get started on the more. The more will guide your thoughts and choices for victory in the days ahead. Resolution number one, say, I will live for God. Resolution number two, if no one else does, I still will. I press toward the goal for the prize of the upward call of God in Christ Jesus. Through the prophet Isaiah, God says, forget what happened in the past and do not dwell on the events from long ago. I am going to do something new. It is already happening. Don't you recognize it? Here is why you can move on from failure into victory. Here is why you can move from less to more of what God has for you. Because failures are never final. Because God grants you forgiveness. When you receive God's forgiveness, your past is over and you become new. The Apostle John said, he who sits on the throne says, look, I am making all things new. Then he said, write these words. They are faithful and true. So, make each day of this year that the Lord gives you a little better than the day before. Anyone who belongs to Christ is a new person. The past is forgotten, and everything is new. Don't wait for the right circumstances to walk in your destiny. Walk in your destiny to create the right circumstances. Destiny is not a matter of chance. It's a matter of choice. It's not a thing to be waited for. It's a thing to achieve and to press for. Commit to your high calling in God. It is the doorway to great rewards. Keep yourself spiritually fit. That way, you can really help others. That way, you can really be ready to serve God when He needs you. Jesus said, whoever is the greatest should be the servant of others. Your influence, your impact on others' lives, not your income, is the greatest measure of your success. See people the way God sees them. It will help them become what God has called them to be. Don't be afraid or too selfish to give. It is the doorway to greatness. Generosity overcomes stinginess and greed, and it eliminates scarcity every time. A victim calls victory good luck. A victor calls victory commitment. So be committed, because you're not lucky enough to always succeed. Overcoming is not about chance. It's more about change. Don't make excuses for failure, and start making choices for victory. Stop settling for being less than what God wants you to be, and start living to become more of what God wants you to be. Walk with the wise, and you will become wise. Don't be a companion of fools, or you will suffer defeat. If you are the wisest person in the room, find another room. Get up early enough to spend time with God. Go to bed soon enough to wake up for church. Create and protect a time to be alone with God. Waiting on God is the secret weapon of spiritual success. Trust in God's word and let His peace guide your heart and rule your mind. Feed your faith, face your fears, starve your doubts to death, and let them die. That is where power to overcome is really found. Don't be pushed around by the feelings of fear or worry in your mind, but be led by the Spirit and His everlasting Word. Courage is not the absence of fear, but the triumph over it. The bravest is not the person who does not feel afraid, but the one who conquers that fear by doing it anyway. You can change your world, or you can try to be accepted by it, but you can't do both. Life is too short and eternity is too long to leave your divine calling in the hands of chance, circumstance, or conditions that are set by others. So do what's necessary, then do what's possible, and God will help you do the impossible. Get God's vision for who He created you to be, then the world as you know it will change. Accept God's opinion of who you are, then you will believe in His grace more than in your own guilt. Since your righteousness cannot be gained through moral perfection, if God is for us, who can be against us? People may not let you start things over again, but God will, and that makes all the difference. Because God is not a man that He should lie to us. So quit living as though He does. In all these things, we are more than conquerors through Him who loved us. And finally, do not become weary in well-doing, for at the proper time, we will reap a harvest if we do not give up or quit. Perseverance is not a long race. It is just a matter of short races, one after another. So this year, God says to you, study the Word continually. Meditate on it day and night, so that you will be sure to obey everything that is written in it. Only then will you prosper and succeed in all you do. This is my command, to be strong and courageous. Do not be afraid or discouraged, for the Lord your God is with you wherever you go.